A lot of you are looking at me, and I know you're thinking, doesn't he work at the rug store down on the boardwalk? I multitask. The Middle East, huh? What do you think? Yeah. It is hardcore, man. No one has sex over here. But everyone smells like they just did. Yeah. We got a Febreze this time. And by the way, can you stop calling it the poopon, please? No, it's a shit lake. That's what it is. A poopon is a place where you picnic and tell the child about Santa. I looked in there, I felt like I could see my own fucking death staring back at me. This place is just non-stop busy. There's planes taking off, trucks rolling around, sirens all the time. Where's England? Brit, where are the Brits? Who's a dude on the siren? Stop being so fucking polite and get to it. Is it a rocket or not? What's happening? It's like, Paulton, there's going to be a little oopsie-diddly coming down in Kaboom Town. Bring your parasol. Man, I didn't know there were sirens the first time I was here. I was sitting in the shitter. I thought I won something. I was like, whoa! You guys are good. Look at this. What a sausage fest. Holy shit. Can I do a shout out to the 82nd Airborne? Thank you for having you guys today. Very hardcore, man. Look at these guys. How are, what's up, sir? What? Where are the females? Now, here's my thoughts. All right, and what's with the belts? What's going on here?
Safety!
How come only some of you are wearing belts? Is that because...
We're in combat.
At the end of the week, you fight each other in a cage match? What's going on? You know, the Air Force dudes, I gotta say, you can take the shorts. Like, put on some fucking sweatpants, all right? Really? All right, the Tour de France isn't coming through here. So anyway, here's my thing, all right? You guys, it's a dry, scary place. What's the answer? Lubricant. That's what this whole place needs. Lube. Every you young guys, you'll figure it out. Lube is your best friend over here, all right? Whether you use Astroglide or my personal favorite, gravy. You've never used a little gravy on your package? Come on. It is the best. You pour a little down there, someone walks in, you're like, dude, I'm making a sandwich, all right? General, are you cool? Now, here's the thing. I remember one time on the internet, let's say, I was watching something about a man and a goat. And, you know, it was a love story. And I would never bang a goat, okay? And I'll pretty much bang anything, but not a goat. But I'm going to go beastie, all right? I'm taking it to the next level. I'm going to do a horse, all right? Because when you bang a horse, you know you always have a ride home. So there you go. All right. Anyway, we got a great show for you. I'm going to be up here back and forth bringing up some great acts. I just want to know before we even go to the next level, anybody having a birthday here? Right here? Okay, how old are you, man? 31. Sweet magic. Do you got a girlfriend? You do? Hey, what happens in Kandahar stays in Kandahar, all right? Sweet. What?
81.
Oh, thanks. What's the matter? You've never seen an older bearded man and a young boy together? Come on. Go with the program over here. It's Thursday. Anyway. Whoa, excuse me. Polite people. But dude, you're married. You know what it's about, right? You got to take care of yourself. Am I right? There you go. Now, I remember the first time I was over here, it was a rocket attack, but I was masturbating. And the cool thing about it is because it was scary. It was like rub, rub, boom. Rub, boom. I'm like, balls, watch the corner. Something's going to happen. Where are the young guys here? Come on. 18, where are you? How old are you, man? Holy shit, I didn't know Harry Potter was called up. What's going on, Potter? You gotta have fun, and remember, keep your balls dry and tight, and keep them hard, alright? Here you go. Balls are where it's at, I'm telling you. And the ladies, we're gonna get to you in a second, too, alright? Yeah. I know you girls take care of yourself, that's why the roads are so bumpy out there. Alright, I know what's going on. General, good? Across the line, after we're at the Pizza Hut. Anyway, this is how, once I was hanging out, right, I got really wasted, and you guys drink, I know you do, right?
No.
Now, since this is an international thing, let's go through the international drinking, okay? Jägermeister, what do you think? All right, Jäger is the ultimate, be careful. Jäger is evil in a can, it totally is. It's like being on a two-person bicycle with no one in the fucking front seat, that's what it is. One time I drank a bottle of Jäger, had three slices of pizza, a handful of magic mushrooms, and a Mento. That's the kind of shit where you're gonna have to wipe your ass and your legs. Have you ever had one of those? That's the kind of pool where if your dog walks in, he's gonna back out like a cat. It's bad. Jäger is evil, man, and Jäger and Red Bull, what do you think came first? Jäger and Red Bull or headbutts for no fucking reason? I mean, come on. Yell what you're drinking, I'll tell you how your night's gonna end. Go ahead, tell me what you drink. Married dude, what do you drink? And what?
Coke.
Okay, good. I'm glad you're drinking Jack and Coke, because I met a dude who drank Jack and Diet Coke. Ooh, Diet Coke. Jack Daniels is the wildest fucking drink known to man. Why put a Nerf saddle on that stallion? He doesn't want to look flabby when he's fighting the cops later on, is that what it is? You'll drink a little bit more fruité than diet anything would be the daiquiri. I don't know who drinks daiquiris. It's a fun party drink. I met a guy who's drinking one, just sipping on it, staring at me, all pissed. I'm like, dude, what is up with that daiquiri? He's like, I'm having a hard day. Back off. I'm like, hard day and you're drinking a daiquiri? What happened? Did a unicorn die? Is that what happened? Jonas Brothers break up? What happened, little girl? All right, I didn't know it was a big daiquiri fest here tonight. You guys, man, this is going to be a good show. So let me feel a little love coming this way. Come on, guys. I know it's cool. I really appreciate you guys coming here. And the other countries, too, man. Really. All right. Anyway. That's what called me out. We're going to start it out with something a little different. Now, we're going to have entertainment of all different types. We're going to start out with a little thing called a little motivation. Now, this gentleman is a master tennis coach and a motivational speaker. He'd like to say a few words to you guys about winning, success, doing it, winning. Come on, Harry, give it, give it. Come on, Kandahar, a warm welcome from Nick Bolitari. Here he comes.